I'm Jonas for Wrong Republic.
I'm Hannes.
And you're watching Metal Mad TV.
We met in school.
Yay!
Yes.
But not the school. In the unit Academy.
Yes. In the unit. Academy of Music in Malmö, Sweden. That's where we met like 10 years ago now, right?
Yeah. Damn.
Yeah.
I'm old.
It's been a while.
Yeah.
That's basically it. It doesn't get more exciting than that. We met in school and here we are.
Yeah. It's like, Juan came up with the idea. I want to form a band. You're a cool guitar player. He's a cool drummer. You're a cool bass player. Let's form a super group.
Yeah.
Called Wrong Republic.
I'm nervous today, actually. I mean, we're trapped between a couple of kick-ass awesome fucking bands. It's like, today is like, competition is rough.
Yeah.
I mean, we have Frank Carter, which is, and the Rattlesnakes.
Yeah, The Hive.
Unbelievably good. The Hive, same thing there.
Foo Fighters.
Foo Fighters, yeah. That's...
Well, I think we can at least outshine them.
We can outshine them,
yeah.
Yes. That's our strength.
Yeah. We shine.
They rock, we shine.
Yeah. What? Metal note. Genuinely love playing festivals. Basically, there's a lot of people. B, you get to meet a lot of bands that aren't same festivals, and you get like, it's kind of a cool place to meet up again. It's like, oh, it was a summer ago since we last saw each other. How you been? And like hanging out. And also, just for me, I was in Royal Republic, I was a hardcore festival goer. So that's perfect for me now. I can do both. I work a little bit and then I can go watch my favorite bands. So I love festivals. All of the bands.
Excited about, I mean, we saw Frank Carter, we toured with them in America a while back. Always excited to see them. The Hives, same thing there. They always put on a kick-ass show, so that'll be exciting. Foo Fighters, I mean, they're Foo Fighters, so it'll be good.
I'm bummed out, by the way. We always miss our festivals. Ghost, I want to see Ghost live. But yeah.
They played here?
Yeah, 2 days ago.
It was very good.
Yeah. With the new, was it Cardwell Copia? That's his new alter ego. It's not Papa anymore.
What's your alter ego these days?
JJ Land. Don't you know?
Yeah, it's a new album, Robust.
Yeah, I really like it.
Yeah.
It's cool.
Yeah.
I really don't get it. Maybe I shouldn't say that.
Well, that's the beauty about music, Hannes.
Am I entitled to that opinion?
Yes, you're entitled. In this country, you're entitled to that opinion. If this was a dictatorship, it might have been tricky. Well, here's the beauty. Variety. That's the best part. To have we are in this luxury position where we can have both. So it makes you, like, when you play big festivals, it gets unpersonal. And you see a lot of people. That's cool. And we play, and then you miss the small shows. And then you play the small shows, and then you get in the faces, and then like, where's the ocean of people? So you get to do both, and that's perfect. We're blessed that way.
Yeah, definitely. And it's weird with the really huge festivals like Download, Rock and Ring, Rock and Park. I was actually talking to a friend about this just the other week, and was asking me, so really, what's it like? I mean, you guys played like 80,000 people at Rock and Ring. And I just realized that when you're up there, it's just impossible to grasp the hugeness of the crowd, you know what I mean? You can't take it all in. But then, like a week after this Rock and Ring show, whatever it was, I was watching it on YouTube and they had like one of these, what's the, drums or whatever, going over the crowd. I was like, that's fucking mind-blowing. Mind-blowing. I can't believe it's us up there.
Yeah.
It's weird.
Yeah.
But it's good. shitty writing process. It took forever, it took ages, and it was painful, and we were crying and fighting and making love, and
it was like a pregnancy that took twice the amount of time. Like 18 months before we were able to give birth to the weekend, that kind of. And you go through so many emotions, like when you're I've never been pregnant, but my wife has been, so I've seen a lot of emotions. It's the same with writing an album, I would say. All this up and down, and once you feel like, oh, this song, this is fucking kick-ass, all right, now we need another one. And then the inspiration goes down, and then it goes up. So it goes a lot of up and downs from when you write an album.
That was a horrible time, actually. Yeah. Took a long time for us to figure out where we wanted to go with the album. It wasn't until we had the demo for When I See You Dance With Another where things kind of came together, and it was like, okay, let's put this song in the middle and all the other songs, let's just do a circle like this. Yeah. So this will be like the core of the album and everything needs to fit this song. And once we had that song, things kind of, you know, came along naturally, but it was tough getting there.
Yeah. Yeah. You want us to explain like how we did the video?
Yeah.
Well, I guess it started off with a good friend of ours, Leo Åkesson, the director of the video. He and Adam sat down with some strong liquor and just started different ideas. And I have no idea who came up with it. It's like, let's do a video on roller skates. It's called that? Yeah, rolls.
Games. I was gonna say roller coasters, but that's
a that. Oh, that would be a cool video, by the way, an expensive one. And it's always like this, like when we first heard the news, like, yeah, this is how we're gonna do the video. We thought we're gonna die. We will not survive this video. Our legacy will be like amazing. Like the band died shooting this video. And it
they
will
died
have,
dancing on roller skates.
Yeah, it will have like 2 billion hits on YouTube. Record label gets so much money from it, but we were able to survive that one. But it was 2 days of pain and agony, and then the director cut it together to make it look like we had fun.
It was horrible. I mean, we had the idea, and then it was like we ordered the roller skates and all that stuff.
And like, protection.
Okay, so now we actually have to learn how to dance on roller skates, and we were practicing outside in like
in December.
Yeah, it was like freezing cold, and there were like construction workers just watching us, like, what the fuck are they doing? We were out on a parking lot practicing. And a couple of weeks before the shoot of the video, you had this skiing accident. So you had a rough time, right?
Yeah, I tore a ligament in my knee, so. It was like, that was painful. Like when we shot the video, we took a break, I had to check the knee, it was like twice the size. And he's like, look, let's keep on rolling, we need two more shots. Like, oh no. But
and I remember as well, the idea for the video was to do it in one shot. Like we were practicing one long routine or choreography thing. And we were like, so the whole point is that we do it in one shot. No cutting in between and blah, 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 we're gonna nail this shit. And when we got there, like we gave like a couple of shots, and then Lay with the director was like, you know what, guys, maybe we rethink this whole one shoot shot thing.
Yeah.
I'll just cut it and I'll make it look off.
I'll do my thing.
Yeah.
God, that's what we did. Of course.
Yeah,
it's time. We're actually mixing summer festivals with writing new material, but it's like always writing the new materials. You can never shut it off the brain, kind of. So we're working on new stuff, and we got a few real cool demos as well. So let's see. We're just trying to speed it up as well. The moon would be cool. Zero gravity rock and roll. Never been done before? Oh, yeah, it has.
Yeah,
in this plane, it's called the Vomit Comet, like the astronauts training. That's zero gravity, they just...
I would love to go to I hear South America is a kick-ass place for rock bands, so I would love to go there and I could work on my Spanish, work on my tan.
Work on your drinking skills.
Yeah, well, those are already quite...
Japan would be cool as well. We've been this close, I think, like two or three times. Like, we've been booked and everything, and then something happened that just like, nah, it's not happening. We've been very close to going to Japan, and that would be cool as well. Because that must be like... What? I have a picture of Tokyo. I don't think it's not getting close to how crazy it might be over there.
Yeah.
And I'm from a small island, I think it's crazy there. Yes. It's always great to play with the Tortenors. Unfortunately, we were supposed to be on tour with Tortenors. Unfortunately, Campino, the singer, lost his hearing. So they had to cancel the two shows that we were supposed to play. So they just moved them. We're gonna do those shows later in the summer. But we've been playing with them like two or three times. And it's like, there's, for being that massive band, they are so down to earth and so nice and kind, and it's you always feel welcome when you come there, like to this massive production. They walk up like, hey, it's been ages, how are you doing? And like, it's like a family thing. Really, they're awesome.